Have you ever wondered about the most incredible plants in the world? Today, we're going to explore the five most fascinating ones. From the tallest trees to the smallest shrubs, the world of plants is a universe of its own. These green wonders are not just for show, they are the lungs of our planet, the source of life, and our silent companions. Each plant is a marvel, housing complex mechanisms that have evolved over millions of years. From the rainforest of Amazon to the arid deserts of Sahara, they have adapted and thrived in the harshest of conditions. And in this vast array, some stand out for their sheer incredibility. We'll journey into this mesmerizing world, exploring plants that walk, plants that trap, and even plants that stink. Each one a testament to the magic of nature and the boundless creativity of life itself. Prepare to be amazed as we delve into the world of extraordinary flora. And before watching, please subscribe to our channel so as not to miss new interesting videos. Already subscribed? You are an incredible person. Kicking off our list at number 5 is the walking palm, a plant that literally walks. Now, before you let your imagination run wild with visions of tree trunks sprouting legs and strolling around, let's clarify what we mean by walking. The walking palm, or Socratea exoriza, as it's scientifically known, is a tropical palm tree native to the rainforests of Central and South America. What makes this plant so extraordinary is its unique ability to walk. Now, it doesn't pick up its roots and trek across the forest floor. Instead, it employs a rather ingenious strategy to get a move on. This palm tree grows new roots towards the sunlight, its primary source of energy, and gradually lets its old roots die off. This process of growing new roots and letting the old ones die creates an illusion of movement. It might not be a sprint, but over time, the tree does manage to shift its location, albeit at a snail's pace. In the dense, competitive environment of a rainforest where sunlight is a precious commodity, the walking palm's ability to move towards light gives it a significant advantage. By literally inching its way towards the sun, this tree ensures it gets the maximum amount of sunlight it needs for photosynthesis. It's a slow and steady process, but it's a survival strategy that works. And it's not just about survival. The walking palm's movement also contributes to the biodiversity of the rainforest. As it walks, it creates room for other plants to grow, helping maintain the rich diversity of species in the rainforest ecosystem. The walking palm is a fascinating example of nature's creativity and adaptability. It's a testament to the lengths nature will go to ensure survival and growth, even if it means developing the ability to walk towards the sunlight. Slow but steady, the walking palm certainly takes the phrase "going the extra mile" to a new level. Coming in at number 4 is a plant that's captured the world's imagination, the Venus flytrap. Now, what sets the Venus flytrap apart in the plant kingdom? Well, it's one of the few plants capable of rapid movement. Yes, you heard it right, movement. But this isn't just any kind of movement. The Venus flytrap has a fascinating insect trapping mechanism that's as deadly as it is efficient. Imagine a clam-like structure split in half with jagged, tooth-like projections lining the edges. This is the trap of the Venus flytrap. But how does it work? When an unsuspecting insect lands on one of the trap's leaves, it triggers tiny hairs on the surface. If the insect touches these hairs more than once in a short span of time, the trap snaps shut, trapping the insect inside. Now, this is where things get really interesting. The Venus flytrap isn't just trapping these insects for fun, it's doing it for sustenance. Yes, the Venus flytrap is a carnivorous plant. It feeds on the insects it traps, digesting them with enzymes it produces. This is its primary way of getting the nutrients it needs, nutrients it wouldn't otherwise get from the nutrient-poor soil it usually grows in. This unique diet of the Venus flytrap is not just a fascinating survival adaptation, but it also challenges our traditional understanding of the plant world. It's a plant, yet it eats meat. It's stationary, yet it moves. It's a gentle, photosynthesizing organism, yet it's a deadly predator. The Venus flytrap is a testament to the incredible diversity and adaptability of life on Earth. It shows us that even in the plant kingdom, survival can take on many forms, some of which can be as dramatic and as unexpected as a plant that eats meat. So, the next time you come across a Venus flytrap, take a moment to appreciate this wonder of the plant kingdom. A plant that eats meat, the Venus flytrap is indeed a marvel to behold. At number 3, we have the Titan arum, also known as the corpse flower. This behemoth of the plant kingdom is a sight to behold. Towering above many other plants, the Titan arum can reach heights of up to 10 feet. Yes, you heard that right. 10 feet. That's taller than a basketball hoop. It's not just the height that's impressive, though. The flower itself can span over 3 feet. Imagine a single flower almost as wide as a doorway, but it's not just its gigantic size that makes the Titanarum stand out. This plant has a rare blooming cycle that adds to its allure. Unlike most flowers that bloom annually, the Titanarum is a little more elusive. It blooms only once every 7 to 10 years. And when it does, it's for a very brief period of around 72 hours. It's like the Halley's Comet of the plant world. Rare, unpredictable, and absolutely mesmerizing. Now let's talk about the elephant in the room, or rather, the corpse in the garden. The Titanarum is notorious for its smell. When it blooms, it emits a scent that can only be described as similar to rotting meat. While this might not be the most appealing feature to us humans, it serves a critical purpose for the plant. This odor of decay is a siren call to carrion beetles and flesh flies, the primary pollinators of the Titanarum. These insects are attracted to the smell, thinking it's a feast waiting for them. Instead, they become unwitting helpers in the Titanarum's pollination process. It's a fascinating strategy, isn't it? The Titanarum uses size, rarity, and even a horrific smell to its advantage, ensuring its survival and continuation. It's a testament to the adaptability and resourcefulness of nature, showing how life can thrive in the most unexpected ways. The Titanarum is truly a titan among plants, with a smell that's unforgettable. At number 2, we have the resurrection plant, a plant that can come back to life. Now that might sound like something straight out of a fantasy novel, but it's as real as the air we breathe. The resurrection plant is a fascinating specimen, a testament to the extraordinary adaptation abilities of nature. This plant, also known as Selaginella lepidophylla, has a unique ability to survive extreme dehydration. That's right, it can literally dry up, appearing dead for years, and then revive with just a tad bit of water. It's like the plant version of a phoenix, rising from its own ashes, or in this case, dust. Imagine a plant that curls up into a tight ball, its roots retracting from the soil, seemingly lifeless. It can stay this way for years, enduring harsh conditions such as desert climates. It's almost as if it's holding its breath, waiting for the right conditions to come back to life. And then comes the magic. The moment a drop of water touches this seemingly dead plant, it starts to unfurl. Slowly but surely, the plant springs back to life, changing from a dry brown ball into a vibrant green plant, its leaves spreading out as if stretching after a long sleep. This resurrection can happen in hours, a spectacle of nature that's nothing short of miraculous. The resurrection plant's remarkable ability to survive and revive allows it to endure in some of the harshest environments on Earth, from the arid deserts of Texas and Mexico to the dry regions of Central and South America. For centuries, this plant has captivated scientists and plant enthusiasts alike, a symbol of resilience and survival. Its unique survival strategy has even sparked interest in the field of biotechnology, with researchers exploring how its dehydration tolerance could be used to improve the drought resistance of crops. The resurrection plant truly lives up to its name, making it one of the most incredible plants in the world. It's a living testament to the power of adaptation and survival, a plant that literally comes back from the dead. Now isn't that incredible? And finally at number 1 we have the Rafflesia Arnoldii, the largest flower in the world. This plant truly is a marvel of the natural world, boasting a record-breaking size with flowers that can reach a staggering 3 feet in diameter. It's not just its size that sets the Rafflesia Arnoldii apart though. This plant is a parasite, living inside the tissue of a vine and only emerging to reveal its enormous red petal to the world when it's time to reproduce. The Rafflesia Arnoldii has a unique reproductive process. It relies on flies to pollinate its flowers. The flower releases a putrid smell, similar to rotting meat, to attract these insects. The flies, believing they've found a tasty meal, inadvertently carry the pollen from one flower to another, helping the Rafflesia Arnoldii to reproduce. With its grand size and unique lifestyle, the Rafflesia Arnoldii takes the crown as the most incredible plant in the world. Thank you for watching the video to the end. If you liked this video, give it a thumbs up under this video and subscribe to our channel. There will be a lot more interesting and educational things here. See you soon.